Hello,
my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX Product Marketing Team, and today I will be discussing how to optimize your Design Space Explorer studies and effectively review the results that they return. To begin, we are looking at a coffee machine, and we are going to investigate how to optimize its water tank volume while keeping its weight in a range that will promote structural integrity without sacrificing the product's lightweight design. I have already began by loading this part into a new window and beginning the study that we are going to perform. As you can see, I have created a design variable that will vary the shell thickness of the tank, a design constraint to keep the mass in an ideal range, and a design objective that aims to maximize the volume inside of the tank. However, the one variable I still need to add into my part is an option to control what material will be used in the design of our tank. To add this in, we must create a new design variable and look under the body section. In here, we will select the solid body of extrude, which is what makes up our tank. Once we click on this, you can see that there is now a variety of different materials that we can choose to test in our study. I'm going to select each one so we can explore the impact it will have on our part. Once this is completed, it now can be found in our study navigator on the left side of the screen. Now that this has been finished, we are now ready to run our study so we can review its results. For this instance, we are just going to run it for 20 iterations, as we just want to explore the trends that we may notice in each variable's impact. Now that we have ran the study, we can find a table and three charts under the results section of the study navigator. We are going to look at all four sections to explore what each one means for the test. The first section under run 1 is the table. This can also be found at the top under results. One of the key aspects in this table is the far right column labeled performance. The performance results section is an incredibly useful tool to quickly determine which variables are most ideal for a task. When the performance result is a positive value, the test was successful, and if it is a negative value, one of the constraints was not met. The higher the score, the better the test went. By sorting by this performance result score, users can quickly determine which variables most directly correlated with successful designs. The second tab under our trial run is the objective history. The objective history is a graph that plots the design objective against each trial run. One of the best aspects of this feature is the drop-down box in the top left labeled design set. To analyze what results were successful, users can switch this box to feasible, which filters to show which trials successfully met the constraints. Alternatively, users can set this filter to infeasible to see what trials were unsuccessful, best to look at the feasible trials that were most efficient, or non-error in the case that one or more instances did not produce a true result. These filter options can help users to quickly find data that pertains to what they want to discern from their study. The next tab under the trial run is performance rating. Instead of the objective, this graph holds a plot of performance rating versus each individual trial. Once again, the design set filter can make viewing these results much easier. The last tab under the results is the constraint violations. This tool is most effective in trials where every possibility is performed, as it can demonstrate how frequent the designs do not meet requirements. This is a simple bar graph and is yet another mode through which users can explore their data. In conclusion, we have reviewed how to implement material application into our Design Space Explorer study, looked at how to go about reviewing graphs, explored the importance of performance rating, and taken a look into using a design set dropdown to optimize our graphs. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.